Hello, my fellow YouTubers and subscribers, and welcome to my latest movie review, where today I review The Abyss, released in 1989 and directed by James Cameron, also written by James Cameron. So, The Abyss. This movie review was requested by a good friend and subscriber of mine, Alan Kalo. Alan, I'm sorry, it's taken me ages to get to this, bad Ollie, but I hope that you will be happy with my review. So, The Abyss. This is a movie I'd not actually seen before I'd done the review. I've seen a few James Cameron movies, but this was one that I hadn't seen, so this will be interesting. The plot of The Abyss is as follows. A civilian diving team is enlisted to search for a lost nuclear submarine and faces danger while encountering an alien aquatic species. Okay, The Abyss. Well, this movie is really good. It's a really fantastically well-made film. I can see why this movie gets so much acclaim. I mean, this movie is, on a technical level, it's amazing. Wow. The aesthetics of this movie are what most filmmakers should aspire to achieve. The visuals of this movie are out of this world. They are so good. And it really just goes to show how much of a technical talent James Cameron has. Especially the lighting. There's a lot of blue lighting here. Obviously, the fact that they are underwater for most of the film, and it really does give you that sort of immersion. It's a very immersive movie, and it's very easy to kind of get wrapped up in the story and what's going on and the world in which these characters are living in. And the look of the aliens themselves, the sort of, I mean they look a bit like stingrays, but they are actually aliens. And I think they look rather cool. I mean, the CGI obviously it is quite dated. I mean, I think I watched the special edition version because this movie was like 2.5 hours long. It was like two hours 40 minutes long, but alas, the visual effects do look very good, even if they are slightly dated, especially like with the sort of water movements. And I know Cameron would continue to pioneer with his visual effects, and he would continue to pursue his advancements in visual effects in Terminator 2, which would come out a few years after this. And especially when the main character Bud goes down into the abyss and he discovers the alien home in the water, it's amazing to look at. Wow, it's like a painting. It's that good. James Cameron's direction for the movie is also very good, and I think he does a very good job of keeping the momentum of the movie going, which is quite surprising considering how long it is. But it's also testament to the length that it is as intense as it is. Like, obviously the first act of the movie is the build-up, and we're getting to know the characters and getting them into the situation, so there is a certain amount of window dressing going on. But once we get into the tensions and they start to build up, the tensions continue to build and build and build and build until you're kind of on the edge of your seat. This is what this type of film is meant to do. It's meant to create the tension so that when these suspenseful moments come, you feel the impact that much more. And that's exactly what happened when I watched this movie. On the length, though, I do feel, as good as the movie is, I do feel like one of the drawbacks is the length. I think it is a tad bit too long. The first act is a little slow. It takes a long time to introduce characters, and then it's still going. So it takes too long to get to the meat of the story, I think. I think the first act could have been trimmed slightly for me. So maybe if this movie was like dead on 2.5 hours, that probably would have been better. You know, obviously, I'm assuming I watched, because I rented this movie, I watched the longer version, and perhaps maybe I should have watched the normal version, although everybody says to watch the special edition. So another criticism I would probably have to give this film is the writing. It's not the story, it's the dialogue. I mean, I've always said this about James Cameron, is that he's a very talented director, but I don't think he's that talented of a writer. I honestly think his writing is kind of subpar. Like, it's fine. Like, it's passable. In all the Cameron movies I've seen, all of his dialogue is cheesy. You know, Titanic, Avatar, Terminator, Terminator 2, The Abyss, Aliens. All of those movies have the same level of cheese that he applies to any of his scripts. I don't know. Like, it's just the only way he knows how to write. And all of his characters do sound very similar. There's those sort of, you know, corny jokes and everything, and it doesn't really fit with the mood of the film, if you know what I mean. Like, one example I have of this is in the scene when Bud is trying to revive his wife, Lindsay, because he thinks that she's dead. And like that moment is so overplayed, it's so overacted. When he's like, "Come on, you keep fighting, you never give up, you know, keep fighting." Jeez, man, like Cameron, what is this dialogue? it's very corny, is what I'm saying. The dialogue is a little clunky and a little corny, and some of it needed to change. I think a different writer may have helped Cameron to create some better dialogue, because not all of the cheesiness and corniness works. Some of it does. Some of it's okay, and it's you know there are some one-liners which are charming and fine, but when it comes to the big moments, sometimes it's a laughable. It's a laughable. The moment when Bud thinks that his wife is drowning, and he just screams no. It's like, come on, Cameron. That's so cheesy. I know this movie was made in the 80s, but it just creates a bit of a tonal conflict, because the movie's trying to be very serious and dramatic, and I can't deny it definitely affects the movie, the corniness, it really does. And on the subject of the characters, I don't think the characters are particularly interesting. I mean, we spend the first, like, 50 minutes of the movie getting to know them. Some of them are okay, like obviously Bud and Lindsay, they're the ones that we kind of focus on because they're the main characters. But other than them two, I don't really care about any of the others. I think honestly, they're really kind of dull. I suppose Lieutenant Coffee is, did they have to call him Lieutenant Coffee? I mean, really? Lieutenant Coffee is probably the only other one, and he's the one that starts to go a bit loopy, starts to hold everybody hostage. And then take matters into his own hands, and then they have to try and fight him in those, I don't know what they're called, but you know, the big yellow aquatic vehicles that they use. They have a bit of a kind of a Robot Wars death match in those. I'm not describing it very well, but if you've seen the movie, you know what I'm talking about. So I suppose he's kind of a decent villain. I guess he's the villain of the piece. That's, you know, there's a great spectacle about that moment there. But these characters are very kind of throwaway characters. Like, they're fine, they're serviceable for what they are, but you're not going to remember them very much. But I like the fact that this movie had ambition. The fact that this movie dared to be, you know, as epic as it was. In terms of the aliens, we don't really get to find out that much about them. But when we do get to see them at the end, and we do get to kind of understand their intentions and what they were planning to do with the world. And Bud manages to, I think he manages to convince them not to do what they were going to do, and realize that, you know, there's still a world out there. You know, we're seeing images of the world, you know, war-torn and all this violence and everything. And then there's a message of, a text message that comes up on screen. And I think that's a kind of, that's the emotional core which stops them from doing what they're doing. There's still hope there, you know, there's still always hope to come back, and I like that message. But like I said, this movie is just a visual masterpiece. The visuals are amazing, and the spectacle when it's there is pretty awesome. I mean, I cannot deny the camera work is amazing, and the way that the shots flow together and the seclusion of the environment, it really adds to the tension. This movie reminded me a bit of Alien. It's kind of like Alien, but at sea. I know that James Cameron directed the second Alien movie, Aliens. I'll go into those movies at some point. I know Alien is slightly different with the fact that the creature is on there attacking them. I mean, the story here is quite thin, but like Alien, it's all about the tension. It's all about, you know, not the destination so much as the journey. Like, what are they going to do to get out of this rather than, you know, the getting out of it? I do think the ending is quite cheesy. When the alien ship rises up out of the sea and brings the sub, or whatever it is, the you know, the aquatic sub, up to the surface, and then Lindsay reunites with Bud, and they have their romantic kiss. It's very cheesy. I also like the music score very much as well. I think the music really works quite well and adds the tension and the atmosphere, and also there's a lot of dark lighting, which also very much helps it. This movie is a great example for people that want to go into lighting. So yeah, The Abyss. I don't have much else to say about it. It has a few problems, but you know, in terms of just, this is my own opinion. This is the first time I've seen this movie, and I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. It's just what I think. So I will give this movie, I'll give it a 9 out of 10. want to thank my friend Alan Kalo for recommending it to me. Is it my favourite James Cameron movie? Well, I don't know about that. We'll see. I still haven't seen all of his movies. I've seen most of them. But anyway, thank you all very much for watching this review of The Abyss. What do you think? Please comment down below, let me know. And remember, this is just my opinion, my own subjective opinion. I'm not telling you what to think of the movie, this is just my own thoughts. And stay tuned next time for more movie reviews. So until then, thank you very much all for watching, and as always, I'm Mr. TARDIS11. See you soon. Bye for now.